The simplest way to create in-page navigation on the web is to use anchor links. They're very easy to set up because you only need HTML to set them up. And did you know that you can actually animate them with a single line of CSS? Find out how in this quick tip. Okay, I have a demo on CodePen, and for our starting point, I'm using the code created in one of my previous tutorials on creating animated slideshow just using CSS. The link for that tutorial should be on the screen right now, and the link for this demo will be in the description if you want to check the finished version of the code. We have a simple slideshow here with a couple of the slides. We will add navigation to this demo, and we will link navigation items to our slides so that we can jump from one slide to the next slide by clicking links in our navigation. First, let's create navigation structure in our HTML. We're going to use the nav element. ULLI, and I'm using Emmet Code extension here, which allows you to quickly create complex HTML structures using a syntax that looks quite a bit like CSS. So that's what you see here. We're gonna have 5 LI elements, and every LI element is going to contain a link with the value href of hashtag slide and the number of that slide. And every link will have text slide and number of that particular slide. Here it is. And I have already prepared HTML on our slides. I've added IDs to every slide. So in our navigation, we have href with the slide 1, which corresponds to the slide 1 ID, and so on. And our HTML is hereby ready. So let's add a bit of styling to that navigation menu. We will add it here. Let's use position fixed, top 0, left 50%. And we will add transform translate x minus 50% to center it on the screen horizontally. And there we go. Now let's style our UL list. We will remove margin and padding. We will remove list style, and let's arrange those items horizontally by using display flex. There we go. And now we can move on to our links. Let's set them to display block, add a little bit of padding, maybe a background color. And our background is gonna be color we already used on our page here. We'll just make it a bit darker. Color is going to be white. And we don't need text decoration. Let's add a simple hover effect. I'm using SAS, that's why I can nest those selectors here. And our hover effect is going to be just a lighter version of our background here with a bit more saturation. Okay. And for our final tweak, let's add a bit of border radius here on the edges of our navigation. And our navigation menu is now ready, so we can check if it works. And as you can see, in-page navigation works as expected. I'm jumping from one slide to the next by clicking those anchor links. And we can simply animate those transitions if we add scroll behavior to our CSS. And scroll behavior is a CSS property that allows you to set smooth behavior for your scrolling when it's triggered by navigation or a browser scrolling API. As our scroll bar is an HTML element here, we're gonna add this property to HTML element. Scroll behavior takes two values. It can be either auto, which is default value, or smooth, which is the value you're gonna see right now. So if I'm using my anchor links here, you're gonna see that our slides are animated here beautifully. And with just this one line of CSS, we have actually animated our anchor links. And this doesn't work only for anchor links, it also works for scrolling APIs. So if you trigger scroll with the JavaScript, you're gonna also see an animated transition. Let's try this. I will open console here on CodePen, and let's select our HTML element, and we will use scroll to method, and we're gonna scroll horizontally by, let's say, 1000 pixels, and let's see if it works. And sure enough, it's animated as well. Let's try scrolling that back to 0, and again, our scroll here is animated. And this is it for this quick tip. With this one line of CSS, we have created animated anchor links. And if you ever want to use, well, anchor links or JavaScript to trigger scroll, now you know that you can add scroll behavior and have this transition go really smoothly and really beautifully. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Nyambor. I hope you found this useful. Make sure to hit that subscribe button, and I will see and hear you in the next video.